Hi, it's Lou. And have you heard there is a new package for COVID relief, and hopefully you may benefit from it. I was just reading Forbes, and they're saying, this is Forbes magazine, $25 billion in rent relief included in the new stimulus package. Is it enough to help renters at risk of eviction? Well, there's a good question, isn't it? So they're saying here that the stimulus package agreed on by Congress this week provides relief for renters worried about making ends meet as the pandemic drags on. But the sense of security may be short-lived for many unless political leaders take action to prevent evictions. The Consolidated Appropriations Act includes an extension of the CDC's eviction moratorium for renters through January 21st, 2021. It also offers monetary relief to some renters in distress, although the details of how soon they'll be able to apply for that aid are unclear. Well, what I suspect there is there's already agencies out there in local municipalities, at state levels, down at the county level, that already have applied for this money in the past. They've already got a distribution network. I suspect people will be going to the same agencies that provided it before, and they'll just have additional funding. I don't think there'll be any difficulty there. All right, so what is the eviction moratorium? Well, in August, President Donald Trump announced an executive order providing an eviction moratorium for renters that started on September 4th and was set to expire at the end of 2020. The order now extended through January 31st, which probably means it's going to be extended again, right? Was supposed to prevent landlords from evicting tenants who don't pay rent for reasons related to the coronavirus, like job loss or income reduction. Under the moratorium, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC, and the Department of Health and Human Services use their authority under the Public Health Services Act to protect renters from being evicted from their homes, potentially becoming homeless and spreading the coronavirus. The new stimulus package also provides $25 billion in financial assistance that households will be able to use to pay past due rent, future rent, I thought that was interesting, and utility bills, also interesting, or other household expenses incurred by the pandemic. So in other words, they're not putting tight little restrictions on how that money can be used and for what it can be used for. So which renters will receive protection? Rent relief. Rent relief funds will be distributed to state and local governments. You may qualify for rent relief if the following criteria apply to you or your living situation. One or more members of your household has qualified for unemployment benefits, experienced a reduction in income, or experienced other financial hardship due to the pandemic. So in other words, anybody who's lost their job, had their hours cut, whatever the case may be, they qualify. The next one, you can demonstrate a risk of housing instability by presenting a past due utility bill, past due rent notice, or eviction notice. So they're not requiring us to file eviction, us meaning landlords, that now the resident, simply by receiving a past due rent notice, they'll be able to qualify for it. And also that you have household income of no more than 80% of the area's median income per household. So any of those three criteria means that you can qualify for the money. States and cities receiving funds to provide rental assistance are instructed to prioritize the following applications. Household income does not exceed 50% of the area median income per household, and one or more members of the household are unemployed and have been unemployed for 90 days prior to applying for assistance. So these jump to the head of the pack. So if you've got any residents that are in that situation, or if you're in that situation, know that you're going to be able to get instant or almost instant relief because of your particular situation. Know that that is a priority. Know that you want to tell your residents that they are priority status if they are in that situation. In most cases, funds granted to renters will be paid to their landlord or utility company directly by the state or city managing the money. Landlords and property owners may apply for assistance on behalf of their tenants with permission from the tenant. So in other words, you landlords, you can take the responsibility, you can make it your duty to go ahead and apply for it for them. And we all know that left to their own designs, some people are in a crash and burn mode. Some people are in a situation where they want to sabotage whatever's going on in their life. So literally, they may simply walk out your door or your meeting or your conversation with them and just not do whatever it is that they should do. So it is incumbent upon you to take the additional step to find out what is available in your area. And I've got some landlord relief right here in this message below where I've got for you a couple of things. One is a link to this Forbes article. The second thing is a list of what we use locally, and you can use that as a template to find other resources that are available in your area. Eligible households can receive up to 12 months of assistance, but may be approved for up to 15 months of aid in some circumstances. Isn't that interesting? So if they've gotten themselves in that situation and they haven't gotten a replacement job, it could actually pay them for another 15 months. Eviction moratorium. Meanwhile, the extension of the renter's eviction moratorium provides eviction protections for people making $99,000 or less per year, or $198,000 for couples filing jointly. So if any of your residents are making less than $99,000, which is all of my residents, I don't know about you. I don't have people making big incomes. Now, this is important for you landlords to know. Any rent continues to be due. You're simply protected from being evicted if you can't make the payment. The order does not relieve any individual or any obligation to pay rent, make a housing payment, or comply with any other obligations that the individual may have under a tenancy, lease, or similar contract. Reads the notice in the Federal Register. So that's been published by the government in the Federal Register, clearly states that you're not, as a landlord, obligated to have to cut your rents, disappear your rents, or not charge the fees that people agreed to in their agreement. Nothing in the order precludes the charging or collecting of fees, penalties, or interest as a result of the failure to pay rent or other housing payment on a timely basis under the terms of any applicable contract. So that's read right from the thing, the order in the Federal Register. In order to be protected from eviction, you must prove that you're likely to become homeless if kicked out of your dwelling. To do this, you have to fill in and sign a declaration. You can print this form from the CDC, which asks you to declare the following. One, your income is within the requirements of the order. You earn $99,000 or less, or $198,000 if you file joint tax return, or you received a stimulus check. Two, you've used best efforts to get all available government assistance for rent or housing. Three, you're unable to pay full rent or make a full housing payment because you lost income, you were laid off, or you had out-of-pocket medical expenses. Four, you've made partial payments whenever possible. Five, that if you were to be evicted, you'd likely be homeless, need to move into homeless shelter, or share a new residence in close quarters with multiple people. So that's some valuable information they have in that CDC piece of paper that your resident can present to you. Now, what we did was create a letter to communicate with our residents that have given us the CDC letter to say simply that we need proof of these items. So the items that are in the letter, just because they gave you the letter, doesn't mean that those things are confirmed. And so we ask our residents to actually give us the details of these items so that we know that they're in compliance with this particular letter. Now, if they don't provide those things to you, then they're not in compliance with this letter. Landlords continue to evict tenants. Housing advocates welcomed the relief bill, but say more aid is necessary to patch renters' long-term concerns. The $25 billion for eviction assistance is a practical start for staving off the immediate threat of mass evictions across the country, said David Dworkin, president and CEO of the National Housing Conference, in an emailed statement. More will be needed to prevent housing insecurity for millions of low and moderate income households who are managing the economic fallout of the pandemic. A report by Popular Information, a news and politics newsletter, found that proving the executive order's requirements may be too onerous for people who are disproportionately affected by the pandemic and who may lack access to legal help. The report found that after the executive order began, landlords were filing evictions proceedings against tenants and challenging their circumstances in court. And that's why I said that you don't really want to get to court and have that conversation. You want to ask your residents in advance if they have proof of their situation. If they don't have proof of their situation, well, then you need to take the necessary steps to protect your business. Obviously, that many of you, in fact, the statistics are that most people have 20 or less properties. And most people who own rental properties are not doing this as a hobby. They're doing this as an income stream for themselves and their family. Many people are retired, and this is their retirement income. And of course, we all know that the income that comes from the residents are being used for important things like making mortgage payments. And that includes property taxes, that includes insurance, that includes repairs to the property. And most landlords don't make a huge amount of profit. In fact, the national average is like 9% that is the income for a landlord. So it's important to know that these payments are very important, and a landlord in failure is also a tenant in failure, because if the landlord loses the property to foreclosure because they haven't made their own payments, well, guess what? Then whoever buys that property, if it's the bank, if it's another investor, they're going to want those residents to be evicted from the property because they are residents that were not obtained through normal landlord channels. They were obtained through a foreclosure, and therefore that landlord, that new owner, can now evict those non-paying residents. So these are tumultuous times for all parties concerned. And certainly if you're in a position to pay your rent, I strongly encourage you to pay your rent, because the landlord does have leverage if you cannot prove that you are not in a position to pay your rent. If you are in a position that unfortunately you can't pay your rent because of the things that I stated there, then there is help available, and you should definitely stop and seek that help. It is available, at the county level. There's nonprofit organizations that have funds available. There's many things that can happen in your life that can certainly help your situation. Do not sit on your hands. Do not wait. Reach out, find that help. Talk with your landlord, talk with agencies, nonprofit organizations, like I said, churches. There's different agencies that are aware of these funds that are available. And I encourage you to reach out and take advantage of it, whether you're a landlord or whether you're a tenant in distress. You definitely need to take advantage of those things. I've got this article down below. You can click on that. I've also got a landlord relief package of a list of things that we give to our residents. We follow up with them to make sure that they're reaching out to these various agencies, or we get on the phone with them and apply for these funds. So this is something that is incumbent on you for the success of your business, for the success of your future. Hey, who wants to evict people? Nobody. If you have an inch of thought in your brain, you definitely don't want to have vacant properties, and you definitely want to help people if you possibly can. And good news, I hope I've brought to you today that there's help not only existing, but there's help coming as well. So hopefully this has been of value today. My name's Lou Brown. I'm here to help. My information is down below. Love this, like this, share this out to your friends, people, residents, or for the folks that maybe other landlords that you're familiar with, let them know about this as well. Look forward to seeing you soon. Yeah, baby.